Hello student, today we will see the third article of unit number 2. In this article, we are going to see the processes and its mapping technique. Processes and mapping. Previously, we have seen the decomposition. In decomposition, we learned what is task interaction graph, what is task dependency graph, critical path. Decomposition has given us the number of subtasks, and that tasks are now executed independently. So how the tasks are executed? Tasks are executed independently by separate processor. So that's why we required processor to map on that task, or the task need to map on every processor. That is called as processes and its mapping. The task into which a problem is decomposed run on physical processor. However, for reason that we shall soon discuss, we will use the term process. In this article, to refer a processing or computing agent that perform the task. So processor is nothing but the process that is responsible for executing the task. In this context, the term process does not adhere to rigorous operating system definition of process. Instead, it is an abstract entity that uses the code and data corresponding to task to produce the output of that task within finite amount of time after the task is executed or activated by parallel programs. During this time, in addition to perform computation, process may synchronize or communicate with other process if needed in order to obtain and speed up or a sequential implementation. A parallel program must have several process active simultaneously working on different tasks. The mechanism by which the tasks are assigned to processes for execution is called as mapping. For example, four processes could be assigned the task of computing one submatrix of C, each in the matrix multiplication computation. Okay, so here we clear what is meant by process and mapping. So whatever the decomposition result we achieved after decomposition, number of tasks, subtasks, that task need to execute independently, and that independent execution can be carried out by processor, that is a computing unit. That processor is nothing but a process, okay? And that tasks are mapped or assigned to each process for execution is called as mapping. Okay, so this is a processes and mapping. So in general, the number of tasks in a decomposition exceeds the number of processing element available. For this reason, a parallel algorithm must also provide a mapping of tasks to processes. So here you clear one thing, that what is meant by process. Process is not the operating system process that we discuss in operating system subject, but here process is the processor itself. It is a computing element, it is a computing device, processing element, which is responsible for execution of that task. And that task is mapped on that processes by using mapping technique. That is the article. Now, appropriate mapping of task to process is critical to the parallel performance of algorithm. Okay. You need to map the task accurately to each processing element. Okay, that is required for good performance of parallel algorithm. Mapping are determined by both the task dependency and task interaction graph. Task dependency graph can be used to ensure that work is equally spread across all processes at any point. Minimum idling and optimal load balance. Now, in task dependency graph, we learned that it is a directed graph having the nodes and the edges. The nodes are nothing but the task that can be used to ensure that work is equally spread across all the processes at any point, minimizing the idling and optimal load balance. Task interaction graph can be used to make sure that processes need a minimum interaction with other processes, minimum communication. So both things are very clear. Task dependency graph gives us minimum idling and optimal load balancing, and task interaction graph gives us minimum communication among the tasks. So an appropriate mapping technique must minimize the parallel execution time by mapping an independent task to different process, assigning tasks on critical path to process as soon as they become available, and minimizing the interaction between processes by mapping tasks with dense interaction to same processes. So how you can perform the mapping, that is given here. So mapping can be done by mapping the independent tasks to different processes. Whatever the subtasks you find out that are independent, okay, and that independent tasks are need to map to different processes, not the same processes. And assigning the task on critical path to processes as soon as they become available. So critical path, we learn, it is the longest search path which execute in small amount of time. So whenever the path is available, you assign the task on that processes, on that critical path, and minimize the interaction between process by mapping task with dense interaction to same process. This is the some of the mapping ideas for good performance. Now you can see here the database query example where process and mapping is shown. Now here four tasks are find out. That's why task 1, task 2, task 3, task 4, they are assigned to the separate processor. You can see here P0 is assigned to task 1, P1 is assigned to task 2, P2 is assigned to task 3, and P3 is assigned to task 4. They are independently executed. Okay. Similarly, it is shown here P0 assigned to task 1, P1 is assigned to task 2, P2 is assigned to task 3, and P3 is assigned to task 4. Now, mapping task in database query decomposition to process is shown here. This mapping were arrived at by viewing the dependency graph in the term of levels. No two nodes in the levels have dependencies. Tasks within single levels are then assigned to different processes. So this is the mapping. Every time the, now you can see after P0 is assigned to task 1 and their union P0 and P1 is given to P0. That is number task 5. Okay. So once the processor is available, the task is assigned to that critical path for execution, and then we got the high performance. So this is the article processes and mapping that tells us about how you can assign the processes to the task or task to the processes. Okay. So this is a very important article. So far we have seen decomposition, then granularity, task dependency graph, task interaction graph, and now after task interaction graph, the processes and mapping, that the task is assigned to the processes for execution. I hope that you have understand all these things clearly. If you are having any doubts or question, you can ask me. Okay. So here we will stop, and later on we will see our next article. Thank you very much.